Welcome to Eye on the Tigers News. I'm Sarah Petricola.
And I'm Mason Foltz. Thanks for being with us for the news we've been following for you. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is in Washington to deliver the speech to Congress that the Obama administration did not want him to give. Netanyahu's mission Tuesday is to use the platform to speak of the dangers of a nuclear-armed Iran. The event has increased tensions between Israel and the U.S. Netanyahu has come at the invitation of the House Speaker, John Boehner, who did not tell the White House in advance that he would ask the Prime Minister to speak, in conflict with acceptable protocol.
With a partial shutdown of the Homeland Security Department possible at week's end, Speaker John Boehner says the House wants to enter talks with the Senate on a final bill funding the agency. Senate Democrats are not interested in joining those talks. The Senate is holding a vote Monday on whether to proceed on the questions of talks between the two chambers. Congress late Friday cleared a one-week extension for the department after 52 House conservatives defied their leadership and helped scuttle legislation that would have given the agency a three-week reprieve.
North Korea fired two short-range missiles into the sea off its east coast on Monday, South Korea's military said in a likely show of anger at the start of the annual U.S.-South Korean military drills that North Korea says are preparation for a northward invasion. North Korea regularly conducts such test firings of missiles, rockets, and artillery, and they are often timed to express the country's dissatisfaction with actions of its arch rivals, Washington and Seoul. Monday was start of the military drills that will run until the end of April.
The number 44 race car returned to its NASCAR shop in North Carolina on Saturday after it was recovered along a remote road in suburban Atlanta, apparently abandoned by the thieves who stole it from a hotel parking lot. While the discovery didn't occur early enough for the Team Extreme to compete in this weekend's race at Atlanta Motor Speedway, it was a huge boost for the small-budget operation in its bids to make the next event at Las Vegas.
Hardy souls who shivered and shoveled their way through February in the Northeast now have evidence of just how brutal the weather was, with record cold in at least eight cities and record snowfall in Boston. The climate centers show the New York cities of Buffalo, Syracuse, Binghamton, and Ithaca had their coldest months ever. The average temperature was 10.9 degrees in Buffalo, beating the 1934 record of 11.4 degrees. The normal average temperature for February in Buffalo is 26.3 degrees. Let's bring in Callie Corey to see if there's any relief in sight.
Well, we won't see record cold this week, but if you're waiting for some signs of spring, you may have to wait a while longer. Snow showers for most of our Monday with some windy conditions before the next weather maker comes in Tuesday afternoon. After a cloudy Tuesday morning, snow will develop late in the day into Tuesday night. We should see several inches of snow before that snow changes to sleet or freezing rain as temperatures rise above freezing. Wednesday morning's commute could be tricky, especially if there's any freezing rain or sleet, so make sure you keep your eye on the forecast the next day or so. Cold temperatures return later Wednesday into Thursday before we approach more normal temperatures into the weekend. That's your weather. I'm Callie Corey.
Five wrestlers, including two who are now champions, led Mexico to a state title this weekend. Let's bring in Patrick Hollow with the story.
Jacob Wilson and Theo Powers wrestled their way to state championships at the Times Union Center in Albany over the weekend, becoming the second and third state title winners in school history. Senior Trevor Allard finished second, Austin O'Reilly third, and Austin Whitney finished fifth. It was the first time Mexico had five wrestlers placed at the state tournament, and the performances were good enough for Mexico to claim its first state team title. Wilson and Powers were both ecstatic about the championships.
Yeah, as an 8th grader, I wrestled 160 pounds as an 8th grader, so I was out man a lot. And I went 9 and like 28 or something like that, and I said I'm never wrestling again. I was ready to be done, because I hated getting beat up. And then, looking back on it, everything happens for a reason, so.
Mexico diver Noah Galuzzo placed fifth at the New York State Diving Championships in Ithaca over the weekend. The junior is Section 3 record holder and was making his second trip to the state championships. He also finished fifth last year. The Syracuse Orange will play its last home game of a turbulent season tonight when it tips off against second-ranked Virginia. The Orange will not play in the postseason after a self-imposed tournament ban was announced last month. Senior Akeem Christmas is expected to be honored before the game. ESPN has the game beginning at 7. That's it for sports. I'm Patrick Howell.
The first week of March is a busy one. For a look at the calendar, here's Abby Garrett.
Student Council invites everyone to attend the Junior versus Senior volleyball game on Wednesday, starting at 6 p.m. No admission fee will be charged. Tickets are now on sale for the Drama Club's musical production Aida on March 5th, 6th, and 7th. Presale runs until March 4th. All presale tickets are $5. Ticket prices at the door will be $10. Purchase your tickets early. We asked one of the actresses, Brianna Jessmore, about the show.
Yeah, Elton John's take on this opera is phenomenal. Like, the rock style to it, the ability to tap your foot. We have a lot of talented singers as well who can sing it.
Spring athletes will need to stop by the nurse's office to pick up a pass in order to be ready for the first day of practice beginning next Monday. And this Friday ends the 5-week marking period for the third quarter. 5-week grades will be sent home with students next week. That's what's on the calendar. I'm Abby Garrett.
And finally, we welcome Svenja with a look at today in history.
On this day in history, in 1807, Congress outlawed the importation of slaves to the United States, effective the following year. In 1836, Texas declared its independence from Mexico. In 1917, Puerto Ricans were granted U.S. citizenship. In 1962, Wilt Chamberlain of the Philadelphia Warriors scored 100 points in a game against New York Knicks, an NBA record that still stands. In 1985, the federal government approved a screening test for AIDS that detected antibodies to the virus, allowing possibly contaminated blood to be excluded from the blood supply.
Thanks for being with us. For the staff of Eye on the Tigers News, I'm Aislinn Fultz.
And I'm Sarah Petricola. Have a great rest of your day.